reason why I'd like to be involved with the Love Life Project is because I feel very strongly about the rights of people with learning disabilities, and one of the rights people with learning disabilities have is the right to a relationship. And I feel
to learn more, to show your brothers and sisters you can do this.
Get a lot of voice food, isn't it?
It's good that we train parents and carers, because sometimes you find that parents and carers tend to be a little bit protective over the person that their child or person they're supporting, and that usually comes in with the idea of having a sexual relationship, because some of them tend to be a bit scared about it, don't they?
Oh yeah, sure.
I see all of us here, we can talk quite clearly, we can chat with anyone. I mean, I have no problem talking to people or training people about sexual relationships.
Oh, yeah.
As long as they don't ask for life demonstrations.
And we've got our training on the juicy bits that we don't have. And there's a lot of information to people. And we showed that to parents of young people at school, and they were quite interested in getting us to teach their children about that. So those parents might be quite interested in hearing from us about what they can do to help them. Children.
Yeah.
I feel like giving the parents confidence to talk about it.
Yeah, so whenever the situation comes up, when someone asks them about it, when they go, I don't know, and they don't sort of shun the person away when they come to talking about it, because then if we train the parents or the carers, then the parents and the carers would know straight away, I know what to say to them.
And there's a bond there. They were, this is what we can talk about, and this is what the parents should know, and the carers should know what the bond is going to be for this, what do you call it?
Training. Yeah. But when we start off doing the training for the parents and the carers, we can't make sure we understand it first to deliver the training to the parents, to the carers, and what we talked about and all stuff like that. Then
that's why we want to do this course, isn't it?
Yeah.
We can go out there, or in the office here, we can talk to people. There's all different observations around here.
Yeah.
We can talk to.
It looks to me like it's quite important that we've got those links, isn't it? So we know we can not only be teaching the parents, we can be passing on information to people with a learning disability. And then if they know that their parents can support them, and their support workers are going to support them, and if the support workers and parents know that the person they care for has got good advice, it kind of brings it all together, and that's something we can do, isn't it?
Yeah, and the right advice as well. Because some parents, I know some parents do talk to their sons about some relationships, but not all relationships.
So I think it's important that people with a learning disability do get to have sexual relationships.
To our companion, to have a friend, to be together if they want to be. And to live a normal life.
Normal. Very enjoyable though, sexual relationship.
And it's normal to sexual relationship.
Everyone has a sexual relationship with anyone. I mean, it's up to them. That's their choice.
Whether it's man or woman, man or man.
Same.
And all the woman and the woman.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, none of us are prejudiced. We don't mind talking about homosexual or heterosexual or lesbian relationships. It doesn't matter.
It's all part of bond, isn't it? Love or whatever, isn't it?
Exactly. At the end of the day, it all falls on that one thing, love. If you love the person, be with the person.